boys and girls take warning. If you go near the lake, keep your eyes wide open and look for a sneaky snake. Now maybe you won't see him, maybe you won't hear, but he'll sneak up behind you and drink all of your root beer. And then sneaky snake goes dancing, wiggling and a hissing. Sneaky snake goes dancing, a giggling and a kissing. I don't like old sneaky snake, he laughs too much, you see. When he goes wiggling through the grass, it tickles his underneath.
I grew up on Ayn Rand. That's what I tell people. Everybody does their soul searching and trying to find out who they are and what they believe. I grew up reading Ayn Rand, and it taught me quite a bit about who I am and what my value systems are and what my beliefs are. It inspired me so much that it's required reading in my office for all my interns and my staff. We start with Atlas Shrugged.
And let me start by quoting from a review of this novel, Atlas Shrugged, that appeared in Newsweek. It said that you are out to destroy almost every edifice in the contemporary American way of life, our Judeo-Christian religion, our modified government-regulated capitalism, our rule by the majority will. Other reviews have said that you scorn churches and the concept of God. Are these accurate criticisms?
Yes.
It's so important that we go back to our roots to look at Ayn Rand's vision, her writings, to see what our girding, undergrounding principles are.
Yes, we're taught to feel concerned for our fellow man, to feel responsible for his welfare, to feel that we are, as religious people might put it, children under God and responsible one for the other. Now, why do you rebel? What's wrong with this philosophy?
I say that man is entitled to his own happiness and that he must achieve it himself.
I always go back to, you know, Francisco D'Anconia's speech at Bill Taggart's wedding on money, you know, when I think about monetary policy, and then I go to the 64-page John Galt speech, you know, on the radio at the end and go back to a lot of other things that she did to try and make sure I can check my premises so that I know that what I'm believing and doing and advancing are square with the key principles of individualism.
And what's wrong with loving your fellow man? Christ, every important moral leader in man's history, has taught us that we should love one another. Why, then, is this kind of love, in your mind, immoral?
It is immoral if it is a love placed above oneself.
And Ayn Rand, more than anyone else, did a fantastic job of explaining the morality of capitalism, the morality of individualism. And this, to me, is what matters most.